Good afternoon, class. Children, today we will be solving and discussing question answers after the chapter exercises and NCERT question answers, right? And thereafter, I will give you 10 minutes for doubt clearing. If you have any problem, any questions from this chapter, you can ask your questions. Okay? Then we will close this chapter, and from tomorrow, I will start a new chapter from geography. Okay? So let's start, children. You can see question on page number. This is 15th page of your book. First question is here is some information about four countries. Based on this information, how would you classify each of these countries? Right? Democratic, undemocratic, or if you are not sure, against each of these, right? So children, here some statements are given. You have to just go through these statements and you have to write your opinion. Is it a democratic feature or undemocratic feature, or maybe it could be democratic or undemocratic both, right? So you are not sure, right? So you children, you do not need to do these question answers in your notebook. Okay, after your questions notebook mein nahi karne hai, you will do these questions in your book only. I will tell you that which questions you have to do in notebook. I will provide you notes as well as extra question answers, right? These are exercise questions, so you will do it in your book only. Okay, so children, first statement is given: people who do not accept the country's official religion do not have a right to vote. So children, what do you think? Is that the democratic principle? People don't have the right to vote. Yes, please speak. Yes, very good. Yes. So you will write here undemocratic. Yes. What you will write here? Undemocratic. Okay. Because people who do not accept the country's official religion do not have a right to vote. So this is not the feature of democracy. There should be no discrimination on the basis of religion. Each and every people get the right to vote in a democracy. Right? Now look at the second statement. Country B. The same party has been winning elections for the last 20 years. Is it democratic or non-democratic? What do you say? Yes? You are not sure?
I am not sure.
Okay. So you think that maybe ruling party is winning elections because they are doing, you know, good function, good you know, working. So the same party has been winning elections for the last 20 years. This is we can say not sure. You are not sure. Okay. So you will write here, you are not confirmed, not sure for this statement. Now look at the C. Country C, ruling party has lost in the last 3 elections. So what do you, what is your opinion? If country
C,
it is, again you are not sure, ruling party has lost in the last 3 elections. Ruling party, okay, it is not about the political party. Maybe any ruling party, they are not doing good. Okay, due to that they lost last 3 elections. Okay, so this will be a democratic feature, right? Because they were ruling, but because of their function, people were not happy, and then they, you know, they didn't get their cast their vote to that particular party. So this will be called as a democratic feature, right? So they, right? यहाँ पे जो ruling party थी, वो use कर सकती थी unfair means to win elections, but they lose election in the last 3 elections. Okay, so you will write here it is a democratic feature. Now country D, there is no independent election commission. What do you think? Is it a democratic or non-democratic?
Non-democratic.
It is non-democratic. There is no independent election commission. अगर कोई democracy है तो वहाँ पे एक independent election commission होना ही चाहिए, right? But maybe there is a election commission is under the government, or they might be influenced with the media, or they might be influenced with the government, ruling party. So you are not sure that this is a true democratic feature or not. What do you think? You are not sure, or it is a undemocratic? It is undemocratic. You will write here undemocratic. Okay? Got it? Now look at the second one. Here is some information about four countries. Based on this information, how would you classify each of these countries, like democratic, undemocratic, and not sure against each one? Look at the country P. The parliament cannot pass a law about the army without the consent of the chief of the army. So children, what do you think? क्या पार्लियामेंट जो है वो बिना मिलिट्री की कंसर्न से या फिर चीफ ऑफ आर्मी की कंसर्न से कोई लॉ पास नहीं कर सकती? इज इट करेक्ट? यस, यू आर राइट. दिस इज अनडेमोक्रेटिक फीचर. ओके, बिकॉज रूलिंग पार्टी और द गवर्नमेंट मीन्स द पार्लियामेंट कैन नॉट, you know, they should not be influenced with any other organization. They do not need to take the consent of the chief of the army. Okay, otherwise it will be military dictatorship. Okay, like in Pakistan. Please mute yourself. I don't want any noise from back. Country Q. The parliament cannot pass a law reducing the powers of the judiciary. What do you say? Is it a democratic or non-democratic? The parliament cannot pass a law. Non-democratic? Read this again, children. The parliament cannot pass, it is written here, cannot pass a law reducing the power of the judiciary. Yes, it is true. The judiciary is, yes, what you will write here, it is democratic. Yes. क्यों? क्योंकि जुडिशरी इज यू नो ऑलरेडी इंडिपेंडेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड दे गॉट इक्वल पावर सिमिलर टू दी मीन्स दे आर पैरेलली पावर्ड टू दी पार्लियामेंट. ठीक है, उनके पास इक्वल पावर है. सो हियर पार्लियामेंट कैन नॉट पास एनी लॉ विच रिड्यूस द पावर ऑफ द जुडिशरी. अंडरस्टैंड, देयर पावर्स आर ऑलरेडी मेंशन्ड इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, सो दे कैन नॉट इंटरप्रेट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. Okay, now look at the C point. Country R. The country's leaders cannot sign any treaty with any other country without taking permission from its neighboring country. What do you say? Is it a democratic feature or non-democratic? Is it a democratic? Yes, please switch on your cameras. Here, Sashwat Solanki, please switch on your camera. I can't see you. Ria. Okay. Yes, Parikal, please answer this question. Parikal Divedi, please answer this question.
I'm not sure.
You are not sure? Is it a democratic or non-democratic? Okay, Shreya, please answer. Is it a democratic? Yes, exactly. Very good. Here, children, you need to write here that country's leaders cannot sign any treaty with another countries without taking permission. When we are signing any pact, any treaty, what is the need of neighboring country? Right? Here, no permission is not required from the neighboring country. Okay, this is country's government's own decision. So, what you will write here? Is it a democratic or undemocratic? It is a undemocratic.
Undemocratic.
Yes, you will write here undemocratic. यहाँ पे space कम है, मैं यहाँ पे लिख देती हूँ, it is undemocratic. Okay. Okay. Now look at the B. Country S. All the major economic decisions about the country are taken by officials of the central bank, which the ministers cannot change. Yes? major economic decisions about the country are taken by officials of central bank. Is it correct? Which the ministers cannot change? Yes. Is it undemocratic?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, because there should be consultation of both ministers and the officials.
Yes, very good. So this is undemocratic. Okay. Major economic policies decisions are made by the ministers. Right? There are certain ministries which look after the decisions of economic financial issues. Right? Then it will be implemented at the lower level and officials will implement, and the further the banks and the all the system will follow these policies. Okay, so here you will write it is undemocratic. Now look at the third one. Which of these is not a good argument in favor of democracy? You have to select and why. You will give reason. People feel free and equal in a democracy. So I think this is in favor or good argument. What do you say, Chumil? Is it good or bad? What is your opinion? Simranjot, why you are quiet? Tell this answer. That means you are not attentive. This question, which of these is not a good argument in favor of democracy? Here some points are given in favor of democracy. So which is not a good argument? Yes, people feel free and equal. Yes, please. International laws, and WTO is an international organization, so we cannot make we cannot pass rules for this organization. Are you getting all of you? So you will write your opinions. Okay, then now next one, you will go through the Election Commission order recalling in our council constituency where large scale rigging was reported. So children, what is rigging here? Rigging means unfair means. They have actually used unfair means to win elections. Okay, that is the meaning of rigging. Was reported. So if Election Commission is independent, so what kind of order they will give in that particular constituency? Constituency so pata hai LSP ko ek particular seat jahan pe ki ek basically ek representative is seat se is constituency se elect hoga, and there will be number of enormous candidates will be there. They will fight they will contest elections for that particular seat. So you have already learned this word. So children, what will be the order given by Election Commission? Please tell. The statement is given, the Election Commission ordered re-polling in a constituency where large scale rigging was reported. Yes, nobody is telling. भाई किसी कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी में रिगिंग अनफेयर मींस का यूज हुआ है टू विन इलेक्शंस. ओके, सो चिल्ड्रन, व्हाट इलेक्शन कमीशन विल डू, दे विल गिव द गिव ऑर्डर्स टू इन्वेस्टिगेट. ओके, दे विल गिव ऑर्डर्स टू इन्वेस्टिगेट दैट इज दैट करेक्ट और नॉट, रिगिंग हुई है या नहीं हुई है. ठीक है, अनफेयर मींस का इस्तेमाल हुआ है या नहीं हुआ है ये पता करने के लिए इन्वेस्टिगेट करेगा कि नहीं करेगा इलेक्शन कमीशन. ओके, सो दिस विल बी अ डेमोक्रेटिक प्रिंसिपल. ठीक है, वो सिर्फ सुन करके किसी ने कहा है, रिपोर्ट कर दिया है कि यहाँ पे रिगिंग हुई है, सिर्फ उसी पे ही ट्रस्ट नहीं कर देगा. दे विल ट्राई टू इन्वेस्टिगेट द इश्यू एंड ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट इज दैट करेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन, इज दैट रिपोर्ट इज करेक्ट और नॉट. ओके, देन if the report is correct, then elections on that particular constituency will be rescheduled. Okay, by Election Commission. तो उस constituency में दोबारा से election किया जाएगा. ये एक democratic principle है. ठीक है, और अगर वहाँ पे नहीं हुई है rigging, तो दोबारा election नहीं होगा. Okay, now next is C point, women's representation in the parliament has barely reached 10%. This led women's organization to demand 1/3 seats for women. So is that democratic or undemocratic? Yes, where are girls? Yes, Divya Kumari, Arav, please speak.
Yes ma'am.
Yes, please tell this answer. Women's representation in the parliament has reduced. Is up to 10%. This led to the women's organization to demand 1/3 seats in the parliament. Okay, so what is your opinion?
Ma'am, women's participation in the parliament has never reached the
Okay, so children, here you will write democratic principle kya hai? Democratic principle hai, women are being represented. Okay, women are being represented in position. Okay, when we talk about India, women are being represented in positions of political power. Can you give some example, students? Can you name some of the women, those who are already having positions in parliament? Okay, what position is holding by Nirmala
Sitharaman?
President. Yes, Pratibha Patil. Yes. water.